So, Jocko, we finally got Bin Laden after all those years, but American soldiers are still, to this day, in Afghanistan. I'll let you have the last word.
Well, this is going to be a long war, and this war is going to continue. This is an ideology filled with evil and hate, and if we don't protect ourselves from them and actively go out and prosecute these targets around the world, they will be at our doorstep again.
I agree. All right, Jocko, happy Veterans Day, and thank you so much for your service.
It was an honor to serve. Thank you.
I'm telling you something, you need to be careful not to get brainwashed into this pro-war attitude that Christians have had for decades, and we as Christians need to stop being pro-war and be tools of the military-industrial complex.
And now for our feature presentation.
Team, my name's John Denton. If you didn't already know, I am hyped. It is a weird time to be reacting to a music video, 3 o'clock in the afternoon my time. But Kanye West actually released the music video to Wash Us in the Blood, featuring Travis Scott, no less, at the time that he said he was going to. I mean, sort of, he sort of said it was going to come out Friday. Regardless, I'm just going to get straight into it, no need to hang about.
Kanye West, who's claiming to be a born-again Christian. We sure hope that is true.
You're Kanye, a true Christian.
And I said, I think he's for real.
We are war with terrorism.
I don't think this is just some PR deal. Nobody's perfect. Most of all,
we are war with terrorism. Their Kanye sources say that he threatened to walk and vented only to his team. The New York Post got hold of his audio in which West compared himself to Stanley Kubrick and Apostle Paul, as in St. Paul.
Bro, by 50%, Stanley Kubrick. Apostle Paul, by 50% more influential than any other human being. 50%, dead or alive, by 50% for the next 1,000 years.
Are you ready for Kanye 2024? The rapper saying he's ready to run.
When I run for president 2024, we want to definitely know what y'all are.
Kanye also saying he could change his name to Christian Genius Billionaire.
We start this half hour with word that Kanye West is waking up in a Los Angeles hospital where he's now under observation, reportedly for exhaustion and stress. This on the heels of a bizarre and abrupt end to a concert over the weekend.
Pacing back and forth on a floating stage over a concert crowd in Sacramento, ranting about politics.
Oh yeah, I'm on my tonight.
Railing against the radio.
I'm gonna take his lead. Radio.
Even seeming to take issue with his longtime friends Jay-Z and Beyonce.
Jay-Z, I know you got killers. Please don't send them at my head. Just call me.
Fans already upset after Kanye showed up over an hour late began to boo. After only performing three songs, Kanye dropping his mic and walking off stage.
Cause the show's over.
The next day, West canceled the rest of his nationwide tour.
It's a shame that it didn't happen.
On Monday, neighbors described seeing an ambulance whisk him away. Paramedics only saying they were responding to an undisclosed medical aid request. Several media outlets reporting overnight that West is suffering from stress and exhaustion. Now, some who had sworn off being Kanye fans after his latest rant are just hoping he's okay.
Number 97. I have you're his doctor, sir. Is that correct?
Yes, correct. I'm just calling for my cell phone. A request if we can have some police backup because I don't think the paramedics, I think he definitely is going to need to be hospitalized.
So if you can just keep an eye on him, just try
he's here with us.
Don't let him get any weapons or anything like that. If anything changes, if he does become physically combative between now and when the police and/or paramedics get their calls back immediately, 911.
Will do. Thank you so much.
Kanye West is reportedly in the hospital this morning for treatment of exhaustion. The hip-hop star reportedly was taken to UCLA Medical Center after a series of erratic public outbursts. West is said to be under a psychiatric hold today, which prevents him from leaving the hospital. Vladimir Dudiev of our streaming network CBSN is here with the latest trouble for the celebrity rapper. Vlad, good morning.
Good morning. On Monday, Kanye West pulled the plug on his tour, all 21 remaining shows, likely walking away from millions of dollars in ticket sales. Then the reports of being hospitalized in Los Angeles, leaving fans wondering, what's going on with Kanye West?
This morning, new details are emerging about Kanye West's alleged mental state as he was rushed to the hospital. Heard on this fire department dispatch call obtained by TMZ.
Rescue 41, psychiatric emergency, Morrill Avenue.
The 911 call came in around 1:20 p.m. on Monday after West was reportedly acting erratically. Paramedics and the Los Angeles Fire Department rushed to the Hollywood home of his personal trainer, where according to TMZ, officials spoke with West for 90 minutes before following protocol for a psychiatric patient, restraining him, and taking him to UCLA Medical Center for an evaluation. Now fans wonder if the emergency caused his abrupt decision to cancel the remaining 21 appearances of his St. Pablo tour. Just 48 hours earlier, the entertainer arrived at his Sacramento concert over an hour late and sang only two songs before this happened.
Stop it. Hey, radio. Radio. Oh, yeah, I'm on tonight. Radio. Google lied to you. Facebook lied to you. Radio lied to you. Radio. Jay-Z. Beyonce, I was hurt. I went down 7 years on behalf of your talk. Black men have been slaves. Obama wasn't allowed to do this. Yeah! And still win. This is the future. This is the way of thinking to make America great again. It's a new world, Hillary Clinton. It's a new world, Barack. It's a new world, Jay-Z. You still can't believe it. You know why? Because you was lied to by Google. You was lied to by Mark Zuckerberg. Right now, press, get ready to write your passive-aggressive LeBron James racist comments. Season 4 racist comments. Get ready to have a field day, press. Get ready. Because the show's over.
I was uncharacteristic of him, but that aside, to cancel a month and a half's worth of tours when a lot of money is on the line, something is pretty wrong here.
a psychiatric emergency. One report claims that is the audio from the fire department dispatch about Kanye. Access has yet to authenticate that recording, but we've confirmed police responded to a 911 call yesterday at 1:20 in the afternoon. Reports allege that Kanye was acting erratically at his trainer, Harley Pasternak's home.
We're on scene here at Laurel.
A report claims when paramedics arrived, Kanye was calmer but still resisted going to the hospital and was restrained by handcuffs to a gurney while being transported to UCLA Medical Center.
And the doctor said he was suffering from dehydration that caused some kind of a temporary psychosis. If somebody is showing that and they're dehydrated, you hydrate them like 5 days ago. So how does he get, how is the doctor saying he's dehydrated yesterday if this has been going on for 5 days? You hydrate him.
They're making it sound like the psychosis is a result of this dehydration and exhaustion.
In which case, you have a drink, take a nap, and get back to work.
According to new reports, the rapper is on suicide watch after being rushed to UCLA Hospital yesterday afternoon. A source revealed he was crazy and delusional, adding that he is having hallucinations and is paranoid. The father of two, who hadn't slept in days, was screaming that people were trying to kill him.
I'm not blaming mental health, but I'm explaining mental health by saying that I definitely was ramped up. I definitely was a bit manic.
First stage is called hypomania. And what that means is it means mild mania. Mike's exuberance during hypomania was excessive to the point that I was bouncing off the walls, making people uncomfortable. Another thing that increased in my energy was my agitation.
Kanye West appearing agitated, pacing back and forth on a floating stage over a concert crowd in Sacramento, ranting about politics.
And what that felt like was this energy was building in my body and it had nowhere to go. So it made me more likely to snap at people.
Hey, good morning, Kanye. Hey, Kanye, are you mad at Jim Kimmel?
I was going insane. I was violent with my friend. I was violent with people in public. I wanted to beat up a child. I wanted to beat up a child.
Kanye's personal doctor is the one who called 911 yesterday and said that Kanye had attempted to assault somebody apparently at the gym that he goes to, and that he was not violent at the moment, but that when cops arrived, he would get violent with them.
Full-blown mania often requires hospitalization because a person cannot take care of themselves.
Yes, I think he definitely is going to need to be hospitalized, so I wouldn't just do the police by itself.
Don't let him get any weapons or anything like that.
They are high risk of harming themselves and at a high risk of suicide. The next stage of my mania was possibly the best experience in my life and why so many people crave their mania. I had the most profound spiritual experience of my life. Everything in life, God, the universe, life, everything made sense, and I felt so omnipotent, so all-powerful, so all-powerful.
During mania, people might experience the presence of God or the presence of a divine reality. Sometimes they feel strongly connected or even at one with nature, with humanity as a whole, with the universe, or with the divine. Others might feel they have an important mission in the world, or think they are an influential religious person.
I truly did believe when I was 16 in this state that I was a prophet.
Before I had my manic episode, I would say that I was very close to an atheist, if not agnostic. Now, during my manic episode, I made a complete 180. I thought I was Jesus.
I am a god. Hurry up with my damn massage. Hurry up with my damn Minaj. Get the Porsche out the damn garage. Even though I'm a man of God, my whole life in the hand of God, so y'all better quit playing with God.
This is why so many people, or one of the reasons why so many people won't take medication.
These pills that they want me to take three of a day, I take one a week, maybe two a week.
They want both the level of creativity that I shared that I experienced, as well as the spiritual aspect. The next part of mania was very scary. I became psychotic.
The doctor called 911 and said that Kanye was suffering a temporary psychosis.
And I had hallucinations and delusions. Hallucinations are when you visually or you sensorily experience things that aren't actually happening. And delusions are when you have beliefs that you truly believe to be true that aren't.
When you're in this state, you're hyper paranoid about everything. Everyone now is an actor. Everything is a conspiracy. You see everything. You feel the government is putting chips in your head. You feel you're being recorded. You feel all of these things. You feel everyone wants to kill you. You pretty much don't trust anyone.
So I was very violent.
I've asked you numerous times to stop.
Because you feel for your safety, right?
Because I want you to stop.
Now you're setting me up, right?
No.
So I took a hammer to a door that was unlocked, but I believed it was locked. And I hacked away at the door. I had delusions that I had been raped. I was completely out of control.
And when, if anyone has people in their family that deal with that, they understand that it can go like Tourette's level when people go manic. When it's really, it's like a stronger expression of what you really feel, or calling from the universe, or a medium connection to the spirits, even the ability to channel, you know,
messages.
Yeah, there are people who could have physical brain damage, of course, where there's actually something physically wrong with them. But most of the people today who are diagnosed with psychiatric illness, or most of the children today that are diagnosed with all these mythical disorders, ADD, ADHD, ODD, whatever, they will tell you flat out, there's nothing physically wrong that we can see.
I was diagnosed with bipolar disorder. I was connected with a neuropsychologist that works with the athletes in the NBA and the NFL. And he looked at my brain, it's equal on three parts. He said that I actually wasn't bipolar.
There's no test. They can't check your blood and say, oh, you just tested positive for ADD. Or they can't do a brain scan and say, ah, it's just as I thought. He has ADHD, because there is no physical component to it.
The actual truth about chemical balance is that it's an actual lie. Nobody has yet measured, demonstrated, or created a test to show that somebody has a chemical imbalance in their brain. period.
The truth is, we cannot tell who is mentally ill and who is not by looking at pictures of their brains or analyzing their blood.
Cancer is certainly a disease. It can be shown with blood tests to exist in the body as abnormal cell growth. Diabetes is definitely a disease. Lab tests can show the low levels of insulin, a hormone, in the blood. And heart disease is, of course, a disease. X-rays and computer images can show damage to heart muscle or blocked passages. So what's there to show that mental disorders are diseases? There's no blood tests, X-rays, or any medical test to show these are diseases.
Is there something where they give you a blood test? No. The diagnosis is based upon just looking at what you do and also just what you tell them that you experience. These aren't real medical issues, folks. The whole psychiatric health industry is a complete fraud.
There is no rational science behind what they think is the cause of these symptoms.
How many people have I cured? Well, there are no real cures right now in psychiatry.
The idea of any, you asked me about the issue about how many people I've cured. I don't know that any of us are ever completely cured of anything.
I have not been able to cure many patients.
I have cured none of my patients.
Psychiatry in all of this time doesn't have one case report of one disease validated, not one. What they do is they meet at the American Psychiatric Association, they meet in the DSM committee, Diagnostic Statistical Manual Committee, and they vote on making new behavioral and emotional disorders. And they vote, and then they start immediately calling them diseases. And they tell people, they tell the public, these are diseases. Total fraud.
What's the difference between the DSM and a scientific book of disease? Every disorder in the DSM is invented. Every disease listed in a pathology textbook is discovered. Real disease is found in a cadaver at autopsy. Mental illness is not. Mental illness refers to something that a person does. Real disease refers to something that a person has.
See people who just mutilate themselves, destroy themselves, cut themselves, hurt themselves, and even to the point of killing themselves. A lot of this is demonic. Now today, this would all be classified as mental illness. But let me tell you something. That is because the world that we live in and the practitioners in the medical and psychiatric community do not believe in God or the spiritual realm. They think, oh, this spiritual stuff, it doesn't even exist. But let me tell you something, it does exist. And if the Bible is the Word of God, which we know it is, then you have to believe that demons exist. So how can you just say, oh, demons don't exist? So a lot of what's classified today as mental illness is actually people who are possessed with devils. That's all it is.
Any weapons or anything like that?
It's the 911 call made the night Kanye West suffered a mental breakdown. According to reports, the doctor told 911 he needed help for a male with mental illness. To protect Kanye's identity, the doctor identified him as Jim Jones.
And then schizophrenia? Multiple personality disorder? You know what? That's like this. Look at verse 9. It says he asked him, this is when he asked, Jesus asked the guy who's demon-possessed, he asked him, what is thy name? And he answered saying, my name is Legion, for we are many. So there's your multiple personality disorder right there. There's your schizophrenia. Because the guy has multiple demons living inside of him. That's the different personalities that are coming out.
Kanye West has made it his new mission to spread the gospel, launching events across the U.S. called Sunday Services.
The chart-topping hip-hop artist with 21 Grammys to his name, now making headlines for a growing movement known as Kanye's Sunday Service.
Now, this past event in Baton Rouge brought nearly 1,000 attendees to Christianity.
It was one part hip-hop concert, maybe one part just Kanye being Kanye, doing a lot of fun, crazy stuff. Maybe two parts a gospel choir and a really good one, as we just saw. And maybe three parts a Billy Graham crusade style revival.
He really has been saved by Christ and it's like born again. You know, for him, it started off as something that was really healing for him, and it was really small and really personal. He dedicates his whole life to the church.
Why did you start Sunday service?
And I remember sitting in the hospital at UCLA after having a mental breakdown, and there's documentations of me drawing a church and saying, writing, start a church in the middle of Calabasas. At my lowest points, you know, God was there with me and sending me visions.
Kanye West is so inspirational. Kanye West go crazy. Kanye West is speaking at Joel Osteen's church this weekend. Joel Osteen?
A lot of people have been asking me what I think about the Kanye West situation. Many of you know that I had a similar dramatic change, and the media covered it about 15 years ago, almost 15 years ago. Dude, in February, it's going to be 15 years. So anyway, I wrote down a few things about what I thought. This is real, what's happened to him. It's obvious. It's obvious it's real. Now, Romans 5 says that God's love is poured out into our hearts by the Holy Spirit. And that's like the first experience that happens. The awakening, the lights turn on. You know that you know that you know that it's real. And so it's like a spontaneous combustion, like you short circuit. You got this love poured into you. You got the power of God poured into you. And you're just like, he's all that matters. I don't care what anybody thinks anymore. And so you kind of freak out. You say some things. You're dealing with your pride, your fame, your riches, your ego. I would be shocked if he doesn't last in this faith thing, because it's so similar to what I went through. It's like, he didn't care what nobody thinks right now. He's just like, God, everything's God. I know it's freaking a lot of people out, but you know, he will find his way. And I know he's saying some crazy things still, because he's Kanye. He's an artist. A lot of artists are crazy. And he has mentioned that he has suffered with mental illness and everything, so we got to give him grace for that, man. Give him grace, man. He's walking this. He's trying to do this, you know. I just hope that egoic mind, man, that pride that comes from fame and that egoic mind, that's the first, like, to resist the change that has taken place, that Christ change that's taken place. But it's also the main thing that needs to die.
The question is, how do we know that Kanye is not genuine?
I believe he's 100% genuine.
Okay.
He's 100% genuine in what he wants to accomplish.
They say in any other industry, you know, you're supposed to do better than the past. You know, like computers should get smaller and faster. But whenever you say, I want to be Elvis, they say, what's wrong with you? But I want to be Elvis.
Elvis always planned to do this huge music extravaganza with all gospel music. And that was in the works.
But now, with the evangelical zeal of a Southern preacher, Elvis tries to enlighten and teach the multitude around him.
What does man gain? But all the toil that he toils under the sun, Joe. I don't know, Elvis.
It was odd because a lot of times the multitude would be all of these gorgeous models or starlets that have come up to the house to perhaps sleep with Elvis or advance their career. And instead of a quick drink and let's hop off to bed, He's reading the Bible to them. Amen. All these girls were gathered around this coffee table, and Elvis started off sitting talking. The more he got into it, the more animated he got.
The sun rises, and the sun goes down, and hastens to the blaze.
And he had a cane, and he's raising that cane. And telling them stories about with Moses, the staff, the blood, the river, everything, the locust. But when it happened, it was all right with them. They had Elvis.
The devil brought me to the lowest place of my life, the lowest year of my life. And I said this year, I wasn't going to go one Sunday without starting a church.
The leaves of Noah's garden, he quoted constantly from the Bible. He would sit and underline, we would just read for hours and hours upon hours.
In later years, Elvis will try his hand at faith healing. He will wander around a Memphis mortuary after dark and ponder the mysteries of the afterlife.
Satan, we love Jesus, but you done learned a lot from Satan. Hell, right next to Lucifer, tell him I say hello.
Penitentiary chances, the devil dances and eventually answers.
I sold my soul to the devil.
Stop the ignorance, we kill the enemy. Sorry for the night, two months are still visiting me. Months are still visiting me. Months are still visiting me.
Now let's back up and let's start in the past with Kanye West and let's follow his history and come to his present day so-called conversion. Well, back in 2006, he was pictured on the front of Rolling Stone magazine wearing the crown of thorns as a messianic figure, and it said the passion of Kanye West. Fast forward to the year 2013, he comes out with an album called Yeezus, which is blasphemously made to sound like Jesus, like he's another Jesus or something, Yeezus.
Let me explain something to you about Kanye West. Kanye West is a blasphemer. Yeah. Who did a tour called the Yeezus Tour, where he himself claimed to be God. Blasphemy. By the way, that's just for his music tour. Oh, I'm sorry, is the Antichrist doing a music tour too? Because he's the one who's doing the same thing.
This is from track number 3 on his 2013 album, Yeezus. The track is called, I Am a God. Capital G, God. I'm a God. Hurry up with my damn message. Hurry up with my damn menage. Get the Porsche out the damn garage. I'm a God, even though I'm a man of God, my whole life in the hand of God, so y'all better quit playing with God. He's basically saying, you mess with me, you're messing with God, because I am a God, capital G. I just talked to Jesus. He said, what's up, Jesus? I said, beep, I'm chilling, trying to stack these millions. I know he the most high, but I'm a close high. Did you hear what he said? Well, I know he's the most high, but I'm the close high. Like, basically what he's trying to say is, well, there's God, and then I'm like right there with God, as God. He's Jesus, and I'm Yeezus, and I'm a God too. Now go, if you would, to Isaiah chapter 14, verse 12. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will also sit upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. Isn't that what he's saying? Well, I know you're the Most High, but I'm the Close High.
I'm thinking that your last name is the God, right?
Absolutely.
So anybody that's a God can recognize a God. Yeezus can recognize Jesus. I mean, you know, y'all know what it is.
So he did an interview where he explained his lyrics. You know, he's questioned about this song, I Am a God, and these lyrics where he's setting himself up as God and as another Jesus, an antichrist, as it were. Here's what he said to explain it.
When someone comes up and says something like, I am a God, everybody says, who does he think he is? I just told you who I thought I was, a God. I just told you, that's who I think I am.
Well, that clears that up. So here are the lyrics from his song, New God Flow. Shake that body, party that body, come and have a good time with G-O-D. This is great stuff, right? I believe there's a God above me. I'm just the God of everything else. I put holes in everything else. New God flow. F everything else. Did Moses not part the water with a cane? Did strippers not make an ark when I made it rain? So God made it rain on Noah's ark, and Kanye West made it rain with money for strippers. So he's God because he rained money on strippers. This is blasphemous filth and garbage.
You know, they feel like, yo, you know, he's got a God complex because he said if they wrote the Bible again, he would be in it. Duh, yeah, I would be in it. I feel like I'm one of the more important people, you know, in pop culture right now. One of the only people with an opinion. The Bible had, you know, 20, 30, 40, 50 characters in it. You don't think I would be one of the characters of today's modern Bible? And people have their own forms of Bibles now, you know? It's a new day and age. People have their own thinking. People have their own things that they're into. People have their own religion. Hip-hop is a religion to a certain extent, and the rappers are the preachers, and the music is the scriptures. You know, it's just like church, because you go to a concert, you raise your hands in the air, you get dressed up, you sing songs, and you definitely pay some money. It's just like church.
Here is the lyric of his song No Church in the Wild. This is Kanye West and Jay-Z. No Church in the Wild. Jesus was a carpenter, Yeezy laid beats. Hova flow the Holy Ghost. Get the hell up out your seats, preach. Now, what does he mean when he says, Hova flow the Holy Ghost? You know what this is talking about? Jay-Z, another wicked rap artist. Yeah. You know what he calls himself? Jehova. He calls himself Jehova, again, making himself to be God. Folks, these people are crazy, evil, blasphemous, demonic people claiming to be God, claiming to be Jesus, calling themselves Jehovah, calling himself Jesus.
The Antichrist shall claim to be God as well. So he's following in Jesus' footsteps? No, he's following in the Antichrist's footsteps. There are sins that are common to man. Claiming to be God is not one of them. Fornication is common to man. Adultery, unfortunately, is common to man. Claiming to be God? Not common to man. That requires a reprobate to do that.
This issue that I'm preaching on of Kanye West and his so-called conversion to Christianity, let me tell you something. This shows the spiritual state that our country is in and the spiritual state that churches are in, that they are hailing this as a good thing. And oh, isn't it so wonderful? What a blessing.
You know, I'm a religious person. I'm a pastor. And I'm afraid that if Jesus came today and saw me and my family and my church, that we'd be the ones he'd be harsh on. And the people in the hip hop culture and the people who the church today labels as, ooh, those are evil sinners. Those are the ones he'd be hanging out, and we'd be judging Jesus for being with them. You know what I'd like to say is, I'd like to say, go Kanye.
You really a Christian? You know, should just shut up for a minute, okay?
These people have lost the plot, my friend, okay? You've got these fake Calvinist, trendy, hipster reform types that are all excited about this. And these guys have the wrong Bible. They've got lordship salvation, which is the wrong salvation. These people that are getting excited about this are showing that they have no spiritual discernment. I'm gonna give you the facts tonight, and you be the judge, my friend, because we need someone to call this out for the fraud and the sham that it is, this so-called conversion of Kanye West. Let's get into the lyrics from his new album that just came out a few days ago. So he just came out with his first gospel album. It's called Jesus is King. Okay, and so, you know, from now he's doing only gospel music. So let's get some of the wonderful lyrics from his new album, Jesus King, because he's totally different now. I mean, now he's a new creature in Christ. You know, you can't bring up those old lyrics. Okay, first of all, let me just read you some stupid lyrics, first of all. Okay, and folks, the reason I read this is because this is what makes a mockery of the things of God. By reason of these bozos, the way of truth shall be evil spoken of.
Right.
Here's some lyrics from his new album. Closed on Sunday, you're my Chick-fil-A. Closed on Sunday, you my Chick-fil-A. You're my number one with the lemonade. Raise our sons, train them in the faith. He's singing praise to Chick-fil-A. What's he trying to do? Just suck up to all the little Fox News, Baptist, neocon, Republican, Trump-supporting idiots and take their money. That's what this is about. Chick-fil-A, give me a break. There's a whole song on the album that's just dedicated to taking God's name in vain. Okay? So here's the title of the song, On God. Now look, if you're my age, you know this expression probably, because when I was a kid, everybody was saying this expression, and even back then as a child, I was horrified by it, and I would cringe every time I heard it. But people would say, on God.
On God is a popular one, okay? How long has this album been out? Maybe a couple weeks.
How you get so much favor?
I mean, I've heard about it.
Except the measure, Lord,
is sure, 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 you know.
That's your love, that neighbor, not the bad. I'm a bad, it's on God.
God.
Light shine the brightest in the dark. Single mothers know they got my heart. And all my brothers locked up on the yard. You can still be anything you wanna be. When I thought the book of Job was a job, the devil had my soul, I can't lie. Like gonna have some lows and some
Okay, we have switched cameras, and this is kind of in our way, sorry. But what did you think? What did you think? Did you like it?
Honestly, I really liked it. Did you like it?
Yeah. I mean, I need to listen to it more.
First of all, it's God's name in vain to use that expression. You're taking God's name in vain, and you're violating Christ's clear command to swear not at all. James chapter 5, above all things, my brethren, swear not. Well, I looked up on Urban Dictionary. There were 9 entries on Urban Dictionary, and all 9 of them, every single one of them said, on God means I swear to God, or on God means when somebody says something and somebody doesn't believe it, then they say on God to say, I swear by God. But listen to the horrible lyrics from this song, where he reveals what's actually in his heart, because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. How you get so much favor on your side? Accept him as your Lord and Savior, I replied. Thou shalt love thy neighbor, not divide. I'm a ride, that's on God. The devil had my soul, I can't lie. Life gonna have some lows and some highs. Before the Grammys ever gave a nod, I wore my heart on my sleeve, I couldn't hide. In 03, they told me not to drive. I bleached my hair for every time I could have died. But I survived. That's on God. I've been telling y'all since 05, the greatest artist resting or alive. That's on L.A. Reid. That's on Clive. That's no jive. That's on God. Listen to what he says there. He says, I am the greatest artist resting or alive. So what's God to him? God is something that he uses to elevate self. God is a word that he invokes to say that he is the greatest person on the planet. That's on his new Christian album that idiot fool Christians are gonna put in their mouth. Oh yeah, good Kanye's. Shut that crap off and listen to some real hymns. Listen to this garbage, it's wicked. Jesus give us strength. Jesus make us well. Jesus help us live. Jesus give us wealth. Is that what the Bible says? Jesus give us wealth?
No.
You know, the prayer that God taught in the Bible is, give me not riches. This is the new Kanye West. And you know what? He is Balaam, the son of Bosor. He is Cain West. He is Balaam. He is of the devil. He is just as wicked and godless. And it's all about the money.
Yeah.
Oh, and here's my favorite title of a song on his new Christian album, Use This Gospel. Folks, people say what's in their heart. Use this gospel. That's what he's doing, friends. He's using the gospel for his own glorification and his own financial gain. And here are the lyrics from that song. Use this gospel for protection. It's a hard road to heaven.
Wow. Use this gospel for protection. It's a hard road to heaven.
Wow. I thought it was easy to get to heaven. I mean, I thought Jesus did the hard. I thought it was a hard road when Jesus picked up the cross and carried it all the way from Jerusalem to Golgotha. Right. I thought that was the hard road.
Amen.
I didn't know that getting saved was so hard.
Is there a desire ultimately to convert? To convert people through this process?
It's not a desire, it's my only mission and calling, is to spread the gospel.
ASU's Sun Devil Stadium in Tempe is packed with people, and it's not even game day. Good evening, and thank you for joining us. I'm Mitch Carr. Rachel Cole has the night off. It is all for a religious movement called Awaken 2020, and one of the big draws tonight is none other than Kanye West.
Now is the time.
A marathon of worship.
You are 5 verses away from being restored.
Building up to the star of the show.
I want to talk to God. I ain't afraid no more.
Kanye West's 12-hour Awaken 2020 event in Tempe, blaring gospel music, causing traffic, and preaching to thousands.
I really enjoyed it. I liked the spiritual experience. I got goosebumps. I really heard the word.
Kanye, joined by his Sunday service choir, performed Jesus Walks before Kanye gave his own message.
They always say the devil trying to play a trick on somebody, but it's like we played a trick on the devil. It's like God getting the last laugh.
From there, a mass exit of fans who showed up just for Kanye. And following up, the guitarist for Korn, well, he didn't appreciate everybody leaving.
I know you hear me. Get back here!
One visitor even remarking how humble Kanye West performed.
I thought it was really interesting. I thought, number one, I thought that he didn't seem to center it around himself.
Anybody got the Jesus is King album?
Like trying to live your life right. People really know you're pushing buttons like tight, right? This is like a movie, but it's in a very light, right?
what's your name, my friend?
Jonathan.
Jonathan, what's your name?
Alex.
Okay, so like I said, I'm not gonna embarrass you guys. I'm not gonna say anything crazy. You know, so I saw you guys there. You guys were enjoying it. So you guys are Kanye fans?
Yes, sir.
How long you been a Kanye fan?
A couple years, probably like 4 or 5 years.
4 or 5 years? Yeah. That's a long time. So you've been listening to what's been going on with Kanye, starting last year in January, where, you know, he was pretty much born again, and he started the Sunday service. So you've been keeping up on Kanye?
Yeah.
That's good. That's good, because Kanye said, look, I'm a born-again Christian now. You know, and he was in Jimmy Kimmel, I'm a born-again everything. You know, so he's like, I know Kanye works for God now. You know, my job is to spread the gospel now. Tell people, you know, the good news, you know, what God wants for you. You know what God has done for me. So in regards to Kanye, have you ever seen a video where he tells you how he was born again?
I've never really seen like a video like itself, but I think just like right now, like if you hear like when he was like kind of freestyling and stuff, that just like is proof enough to me that he's like a completely different person.
I wanna talk to God, I ain't afraid no more. They always say the devil trying to play a trick on somebody, but and like we play the trick on the devil, it's like God getting the last laugh. I started with this song. And this whole time, devil had thought he had me. It's like they would have blocked it or something if they knew we was gonna be here one day. It's a Trojan horse if I ever seen one. Seemed like God got the last laugh. Soon as I heard the oohs. Have you heard the good news? Give you the top.
don't want us to be brave. So you tell the devil today that we'll no longer be his slave.
Okay, so very simply put, you're a Kanye fan, right? You've been listening to him the whole year?
Yeah.
So you know what's been going on the whole year?
Yeah.
So he was born again last year, January timeframe, he started his, what is it called? The Sunday service, right?
Yeah.
Where every single Sunday he's sung different places. So have you been keeping up on what he believes as far as being born again, all of that?
For the most part.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
So when it comes to you personally, if you died right now, are you 100% sure you're going to heaven?
For me, I mean, I grew up in church. Yeah. Like, I was born in church.
So you're pretty sure, but you don't. You're not 100. You wouldn't say you're 100% sure, right?
I know the way I'm living right now. I wouldn't say no.
No problem.
No.
Are you guys born again Christians? Would you consider yourself to be born again Christians? You're like, no, maybe so. How about another question? If you guys were to die tonight, are you 100% sure that you'd be in heaven?
I think by the way I live my life, I'm just like doing everything that I think is right.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah, I'm not 100% because I don't know if I can believe in heaven 100%.
Yeah.
So, you know. But
yeah, how about
no,
you?
No, for me, it's the same with him. Like, I feel like as long as I'm a good person,
yeah,
and I follow my morals and my moral compass, like my heart and everything, I feel like, you know, there should be anything bad that happens to me as long as I do what I thought was right.
So, somebody explain this to me. If Kanye is just supposedly just sold out, dedicated, wanted to preach the gospel and everything, why do none of his songs talk about the gospel or teach it? They're just a bunch of our God's an awesome God chanting type fluff garbage. Nothing about actual doctrine or the Bible or talking about, look, the death, burial, resurrection of Christ, justification by faith, this is how we're saved, this is what we have to do to be saved. When has he even gotten up and said, hey, here's how I got saved, here's what I did in order to be saved, or here's what salvation means to me, here's what it means when I say that I'm saved? Just any giving Bible verses or explaining what he believes? No, nothing. You can't. I searched all day. There's nothing.
I still think he's saved.
Based on what? There's nothing that comes out of his mouth that even kind of indicates that he could possibly have actually gotten saved. Everything is trash. Everything, look, out of the abundance of the mouth, if he had Jesus in his heart and he's so dedicated in every day and every song, then wouldn't something godly come out of his mouth at some point where he'd actually explain, hey, here's what, I mean, he gathers millions of people together. Right? He's got millions of people all gathered and live streaming. He's got, you can see him on stage with just thousands and tens of thousands of people gathered together. Millions of people live streaming and watching on YouTube. And what does he say? Does he get up and say, hey, listen, Jesus died on the cross for our sins. He rose again 3 days later. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Does he say anything even like that? How long did that take me? 30 seconds? He gets up for 12 minutes. It's just like, nobody beats God. Oh, our Father, dear Jesus, I just thank you for my mommy that met my daddy and my mom that met my dad and put me in a house where my mom met my dad and gave birth to me because I'm God, is basically what he's saying. I mean, the biggest thing he's thankful for is that his dad impregnated his mom, because that's how he could get here. That's his testimony. Go to his testimony and he's thanking God that he was born, because he's God's gift to the world. He's a sick person. And you know what? If you think that Kanye West is saved, you are a complete idiot. If you think that Kanye West is serving God or praising God or glorifying God or doing great things for God, you are a complete idiot. You have no discernment. Titus chapter 1, also 1 Timothy chapter 4 speaks of those who are false prophets as speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron. So their conscience has been seared with a hot iron. What does that mean? Well, think about this. What if you have your fingerprints on your fingers and you just seared them or just melted the tips of your fingers and it's just gone? There's no indication. So when the Bible talks about having the conscience seared with a hot iron, you know, it's the conscience is no longer functioning. The conscience has been numbed or destroyed or rendered useless. Their past feeling. Look what Titus chapter 1 verse 14 says, not giving heed to Jewish fables and commandments of men that turn from the truth. Unto the pure all things are pure, but unto them that are defiled and unbelieving is nothing pure, but even their mind and conscience is defiled. The mind and conscience is defiled. They profess that they know God, but in works they deny him, being abominable and disobedient, and unto every good work reprobate. So many of the false prophets and false teachers and religious charlatans are psychopaths.
My name is Bishop Ron Gibson.
I'm Bishop Clarence E. McClendon. The Bible says that I wish above all things that you would prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. I believe that.
P. Diddy, Jay-Z, they're not the only ones who should be driving Ferraris and living in large houses.
The Bible says that those who sow among us should reap from us. That's implying that the preacher's to be taken care of.
They're what the worldly psychologists call the corporate psychopath, if you saw that documentary. The corporate psychopath, the one who's not out there just being a serial killer, but he is still just totally unscrupulous, willing to hurt anyone for his own gain. He'll lie, he'll send people to hell, he doesn't care. He'll teach lies for money. All that matters is his own fame, his own success, his own financial gain.
What I love about being Christian is I've always been an innovator, but it always seemed like all the innovators were working for, I don't know, Ayn Rand, I heard the term, or something like these ideas that there is no God, all this, and it's just working for the valuation of a company, mm-hmm. as opposed to working for the rebirth, or it's not a rebirth, I might not find the right word, but working for a renewal of the planet and a humility in humanity to understand that we will not destroy the earth. We could destroy the resources.
We can destroy ourselves.
And we destroy ourselves and sure. then the earth goes on.
Sure.
So regardless of what's happening at Wall Street and what's happening at the board, at the, you mm-hmm. know, with trade and what's happening, a Pangea type mentality, mm-hmm. a UN mm-hmm. coming together, a UN mm-hmm. coming together. One thing, no matter what side you're on, you're considered to be a bad guy or a good guy. Everybody wants a similar thing, and that's for the world to be better for their children. Mm-hmm. So if someone's fighting in a war, mm-hmm. they want the world to be better for their children.
Yeah.
And what we're not realizing, being all God's creation, is we have so much more in common than we think. I think there's something planted in us, this idea of, you know, human nature, even something I was saying, I saw on Silicon Valley where this guy was like, I don't want the world to be fixed if I'm not the one fixing it. Something. But
no, you're right. We put us, you know, we do. We always put ourselves right in the center of trying to solve things. But I often think that as society, we lack direction and the unity needed to do it as one, right?
We don't always have to be the one that does it. You know, this interview alone might do it. I could be in there and, you know, have these ideas of civil engineering and using aqueducts and sustainable gardening and farming. But there's people out there that are going to see this and they're like, they're going to come to the table and say, you know, I've studied this for 10 years. I've studied this for 10 years. I've studied this for 10 years. And it's something where everybody, all the Fortune 500 companies, all the founders have to come to the table.
The next thing that we're going to see happen prophetically is what's called the tribulation.
In Sweden, the microchips are already here.
You like to touch it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, weird. Yeah, it's like a grain of rice.
Yeah, a grain of rice.
Embedded in his hand is a microchip that serves as his keys, his ID, and his wallet.
Microchip implants use the same technology that's in contactless credit cards,
which have made cash pretty much obsolete in Sweden.
No cash.
At this tech fair, a chipping event for those on the cutting edge, merging their hands with this new technology.
In the future, do you think everyone is going to be chipped?
I think it'll be voluntary, but I am certainly convinced that millions of people will find it very, very valuable to have a smart device under their skin.
And so you just scan your hand under a barcode, and it'll scan you, it'll take the money out of your account. You don't have to worry about leaving your wallet at home. You don't have to worry about your credit card being stolen. It's all just completely cashless. But then there's gonna be one catch. You know, you don't get the chip, you don't get the mark of the beast unless you worship the Antichrist, something that believers aren't gonna do. And the Bible says that basically this is Satan's plan to make war on the believers, to make war on the saints, to have them killed, to persecute them. And it's going to succeed. It says that he's going to make war on the saints. He's going to overcome them. And many will be killed. But I'll say this, we will not all be killed because this will be cut short. And the Bible says, except those days should be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, they shall be shortened. And the Bible says that in the midst of this, Jesus Christ will return. Just when they think they've defeated Christianity, they've got their global government, they've got their one world government with Satan at its head, Jesus Christ comes in the clouds, and that's when the rapture takes place, and that's when he begins to pour out his wrath on this earth. And you can read about it in Revelation. He's going to be turning water into blood. He's going to be scorching the trees and grass. He's going to be sending these locusts from hell that are going to be stinging people with tails like scorpions. We can already see these things beginning to happen. This is not a fairy tale. This is really going to happen. It's already getting harder and harder to use cash. There are places that don't even accept cash sometimes now. And we're going to keep going toward a cashless society and a one world government, one world currency, and one world religion. That's why you're constantly hearing this preach, tolerance. We need to all accept other people's religions and respect them. We all believe in the same God. It's all getting everybody to ready to join hands and all have the same religion, the same leader. So here's an article that I found called Kanye West Defends Mormons, Catholics, and T.D. Jakes and Says We All Have the Same Gospel. Hey, as long as you believe that Jesus died for your sins, then you know the gospel. That's the gospel. No, friend, there's more to the gospel than that. Not only that, but he is rebuking people for being against Mormons and Catholics because he believes that we all have the same gospel. Don't be telling me that Mormons got an extra book. Yeah, I will tell you that they have an extra book.
That's right.
Kanye West, if you're out there, the Mormons have an extra book. Damn it. It's simple. Christians be making it too hard for people to come and get involved in this. It's a fulfillment of Bible prophecy. Don't tell me we're not headed toward a one world government. The United Nations has more power every year. We're getting more and more united, and someday these things will happen exactly as the Bible said. We can already see it. It may even happen in our lifetime, and I hope you remember what I'm saying right now. When you see these things start to happen, I hope this clicks, and you're like, that extremist pastor was right.
A Pangea-type mentality, a UN.
Who are the founders right now that you're speaking to?
All of them in this interview. Give me a call.
Kanye West has openly talked about selling his soul to the devil. Now, a lot of people wonder, hey, is that even real? Can you really sell your soul to the devil? Hey, I'm sure if you try it, the devil will probably take you up on it. And he talked about the perks that he got in return for selling his soul to the devil. Well, you know, it doesn't look to me like he's gotten a refund on that because he still has all the perks and he's still making all the money off of his satanic, Christ-hating albums like the Yeezus album. I don't see him demanding that all the copies of Yeezus be burned and, hey, don't you dare listen to that wicked music. He's still making tons of money off of that garbage that he put out. And the fact that Kanye West is preaching a false gospel, the self-reformation, repent of your sins gospel, is no small matter because that gospel is leading people to hell. People are not believing the true gospel of faith alone because they're sucked into this garbage that's preached by a bunch of people and now Kanye West is preaching it. This turn over a new leaf and thou shalt be saved. Turn from all your sins and thou shalt be saved. No, it's believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. And the Bible says, if any man preach any other gospel unto you, then that which ye have heard of us, it says, let him be accursed. And so therefore, Kanye West is accursed for preaching the wrong gospel. For people to think that he's saved now and get angry if anyone questions his salvation when he openly said that he sold his soul to the devil.
So he sold his soul to the devil. According to him, the devil gave him all this fame and glory. Well, he still got all the fame and glory, still got all the money, he still got everything. Because he's still working for the devil, that's why.
You know, the Bible's really clear on salvation. It's not based on how good you are. A lot of people think they're pretty good, you know, and yeah, they're going to get to heaven because they're pretty good. But the Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The Bible says, that as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. I'm not righteous, you're not righteous. And if it were our goodness that would get us into heaven, none of us would be going. Because the Bible even says in Revelation 21:8, it says, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and sorcerers and whoremongers and idolaters, and listen to this, and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. I've lied before. Everybody's lied before. So we've all sinned, and we've done stuff worse than lying, let's face it. We all deserve hell. But the Bible says, but God commandeth his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And so Jesus Christ, because he loves us, came to this earth. The Bible says he was God manifest in the flesh. God basically took on human form. He lived a sinless life. He did not commit any sin. And of course, they beat him and spit on him and nailed him to the cross. The Bible says that when he was on that cross, he himself bare our sins in his own body on the tree. So every sin you've ever done, every sin I've ever done, it was as if Jesus had done it. He was being punished for our sins. And then, of course, they took his body when he died. They took his body and buried it in the tomb. And his soul went down to hell for 3 days and three nights, Acts 2:31. 3 days later, he rose again from the dead. He showed unto the disciples the holes in his hands. And the Bible's really clear that Jesus did die for everybody. It says that he died not for our sins only, but also for the sins of the whole world. But there's something that we must do to be saved. The Bible says, it has that question in Acts 16, what must I do to be saved? And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved in thy house. And that's it. He didn't say, join a church and you'll be saved, get baptized and you'll be saved, live a good life and you'll be saved, repent of all your sins and you'll be saved. No, he said, believe. And even the most famous verse in the whole Bible that's written on the bottom, I mean, the reference is written on the bottom of the cup at In-N-Out Burger. I mean, it's so famous, everybody's heard of it, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And everlasting means everlasting, means forever. And Jesus said, I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish. Neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. The Bible says in John 6:47, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me hath everlasting life. So if you believe on Jesus Christ, the Bible says you have everlasting life. You're going to live forever. You can't lose your salvation. It's eternal. It's everlasting. Once you're saved, once you believe on him, you're saved forever. And no matter what, you can never lose your salvation. Even if I were to go out and commit some awful sin, God will punish me for it on this earth. If I went out and killed somebody today, you know, God's going to make sure I get punished. I'm going to prison or far worse or the death penalty. Whatever this earth punishes me, and God's going to make sure I get punished even more. But I'm not going to hell. There's nothing I can do to go to hell because I'm saved. And if I went to hell, God lied because he promised that whoever believeth in him has everlasting life. And he said, whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. That's why there are a lot of examples of people in the Bible who did some really bad stuff, yet they made it to heaven. How? Because they were so good? No, it's because they believed on the Lord Jesus Christ. Their sins are forgiven. Other people who may have lived a better life in the world's eyes, or maybe even really they lived a better life, they don't believe in Christ. They're going to have to go to hell to be punished for their sins. And let me just close on this one thought. One thing that I wanted to be sure and bring up today is that there was a question that was asked to Jesus by one of his disciples. And that question was this: are there few that be saved? That's a good question, right? I mean, are most people saved? Or is it few that are saved? Now, who here thinks that most people are going to heaven? Most people in this world are going to heaven. Yeah, guess what the answer was? He said, in Matthew 7, for example, he said, enter ye in at the straight gate. He said, because wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat, because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. And then he went on to say this. He said, not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful works. And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. And so you see, there are people out there. First of all, the majority of this world doesn't even claim to believe in Jesus. Thankfully, the majority of this classroom claims to believe in Jesus. Okay, but the majority of the world does not claim to believe in Jesus. But God warned that even amongst those who claim to believe in Jesus, even amongst those that call him Lord, many will be saying to him, we did all these wonderful works. Why aren't we saved? He's going to say, depart from me. I never knew you. That's because salvation is not by works. And if you're trusting your own works to save you, if you think you're going to heaven because you've been baptized, or if you think I think you have to live a good life. I think you have to keep the commandments to be saved. I think you have to go to church. I think you got to, turn from your sins. If you're trusting in your works, Jesus is going to say to you one day, depart from me. I never knew you. You have to have all your faith in what he did. You have to put your faith in what Jesus did on the cross when he died for you. He's buried and rose again. That's your ticket into heaven. If you're trusting all the things, I'm going to heaven because I'm such a good Christian and I do all these wonderful things. He's going to say, depart from me. And notice what he said. Depart from me. I never knew you. Not I used to know you. Because once he knows you, remember I mentioned this earlier, it's everlasting. It's eternal. Once he knows you, you're saved forever. But he's going to say, depart from me. I never knew you. Because if you go to hell, it's because he never knew you. Because once he knows you, he knows you. It's just like my children will always be my children. When you're born again, when you're his child, you'll always be his child. You may be the black sheep of the family. You may be somebody who gets disciplined by God heavily on this earth. You can screw up your life down here, but you can't screw that up. You're saved. It's a done deal. And so that's the main thing that I wanted to present to you about the end times. And we do have just a few minutes for questions about either salvation or about the end times.